But of course, productivity or the deliverability analysis is not enough, because it usually only consider about the reservoir performance, the inflow performance. Okay, we need to look this system as a whole, and that's why, as a reservoir engineer, we need to also understand about nodal analysis. Nodal analysis, it involves the reservoir performance, the inflow side, and the well performance, the outflow side. Okay, if we combine the reservoir performance and well performance, we get nodal analysis. Basically the same. So you have reservoir, you have your well, you have your separator, you have the pressure data for each nodal site, each node. Okay, so you have the first node, the reservoir, you know the reservoir pressure, you know the separator pressure. Okay, and then you produce your well, you construct the IPR first, and then you flow, you get the flow rate, you get the pressure, and then you study the outflow performance, and then you construct VLP or outflow performance. Okay, the intersection of inflow and outflow is actually our operating point or operating condition. So it means that our well is now operating at this location within our plot. Okay, of course, we can increase our flow rate, we can decrease our flow rate. How? We can see, yeah, this is basically the same thing. So you plot your inflow and you plot your outflow, the intersection is the operating point. So you're operating under this condition, the flow rate of 2,111 stock tank barrel per day and bottom hole flowing pressure of 1,957 PSI. You can increase your production rate using this one. So we have three inflows, we have three outflows, which come basically from the same well. We just do sensitivity analysis. Okay, so the first one, the inflow. Inflow with skin of -2. So skin negative means that you are in stimulated condition. Maybe you do acidizing or maybe you do hydraulic fracturing. So you decrease your skin to be in the negative side, so you have bigger inflow. It will give you higher flow rate. Skin zero, base case, and skin two, formation damage case. So you have three inflows, and you can also do sensitivity for tubing size. You try three sizes, the first one 3 inches, and then 3.5 inches and 4 inches. Of course, 4 inches will give you higher flow rate. Okay, and then maybe after you do economic analysis, you know that, yeah, I want to install 4-inch tubing and I want to do stimulation, so that I can get this high flow rate as my operating condition. Okay, it will give me more gas, in this case, gas, okay? More gas or more oil, and it will be economic if we do the job, okay? If we do the tubing installation and the stimulation, okay? Of course, as an engineer, you need to do economic analysis before conducting or performing your activity, whether it is infill drilling, stimulation, workover, artificial lift installation, and so on and so forth. Okay, so this is the fourth analysis. And yeah, so you have this scenario and this scenario. And you can also do IPR or nodal analysis plotting based on the history. So like in this case, our first point is here, we construct the IPR, our operating point is here. And then we go further, we convert the flowing well to ESP well, and the production decrease, but there is no damage, there is no formation damage. We have our condition here, but it is located on the same IPR curve, which means that we don't have any formation damage. Okay, here. All right. But something happened here. So our production rate becomes very, very, very low. We are now in 0.3. You can see damage well IPR. The IPR curve is very, very thin, very, very slim. Okay, that's why we do fracturing. So our production rate is increased significantly. We are now inside 0.4. We are now here. You can see there is a significant production increase. But we want to upgrade the ESP. We do the ESP upgrading here, but it lays on the same IPR curve. Okay, so this kind of analysis, historical nodal analysis, you can also do to improve the quality of your analysis. And then of course we need to do pressure transient analysis. It's a specialty of the reservoir engineer.